We'll get to it. Sakura! Sakura!
Are you ready?
Yeah, it's the bunny outfit. You're wearing the sundress. The sundress is cute, too. Let's see here. This character is weird. Mobility, her dash is pretty good. It's a pretty good dash. Her back dash is not as good. It's like par for the course. Relatively normal back dash. She does have a way to alter her jump arc with her Tatsu. It's not great, but it's there. Literally anything is better than nothing. Her focus attack is really big. It's one of the biggest focus attacks in the game. She actually is temporarily immune to lows when she releases the focus attack, similar to, I think, Juri? Definitely Elena. So you can, like, after, like, situations, like, let's say, hold on, stop. Like, if I do, like, something like this, and then I hold it, you can, it'll beat lows. Like, FADCs will beat lows. So it's kind of a little, Sakura doesn't use that much, but it's there, and it's kind of cool. You can use it, you know, you can use it to kind of poke a low to some degree. This is a neat little thing about her focus attack. The range looks kind of wonky. It's not, it's kind of got a weird looking hitbox. It goes out farther than it goes down, so even though it beats lows, like, it doesn't, if the opponent's low, they might not necessarily get hit compared to if they're standing, because it goes farther forward than it does down. So, like, there's a weird little range where if they're crouching, it might not hit. But it goes really far, and she, like, shrinks a little bit before she does it, which actually does change her hitbox. So, it's, like, a pretty good focus attack, all things considered. It's a really cheap focus attack. It's really odd the way it works. And I think, sure, charge time is, like, on the high end, because I think it's not actually universal. I think it differs by a couple frames, and she hits level 2 faster than most characters do. I'm pretty sure that's true, but don't quote me. I certainly see Sakura's focus all the time, so it's a good thing to go for her. Anyway, let's talk normals. As a whole, Sakura's normals are fucking retarded. They're all a little bit stubby. Her range is not that good. The frame data is completely incredible. The speed is completely incredible. Like, the frame advantage is completely incredible. Everything about the normals from a frame data standpoint is just nuts. But they are pretty stubby. Pretty stubby normals. Stand jab is 3 frames. It doesn't go that far. But it's like plus 6, I think. It's like plus a lot. And it's fast enough to combo into her sweep. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, there you go. So that's just how frame advantage it is. And it's like a 2-frame link into her low forward.
It's super consistent.
Yeah, super consistent. It actually gets crouching opponents better than most jabs do, which is a nice little thing. It's so frame advantage that she actually has time to, like, walk in between jabs and still combo them. It's pretty precise, but you see, like, Chris G go for stuff like this, and it actually lets you get, like, four jabs in if you're quite good at it. And that just gives you a lot of frame. That gives you a lot of, it's very riskless is the thing that really sells it. It's like, Sakura can just, like, if she predicts a backdash, she could just walk in and jab, and that's not a super risky thing if they do backdash, or even if they don't backdash. And then if you ever see the jabs hitting, you can just convert, like, really easily at a DX, but normally you do hard. You can just turn even, like, any number of jabs into, like, a low forward, regardless. And crouch jab is pretty much the same way, but I think crouch jab is a bit more stubby. It's got pretty much the same frame data. I think you can't combo that one into sweep. I think you have one additional frame on the stand jab. But it still works into low forward. So I guess, I don't think that's 1 frame, I think that's 2. So I guess this must be 3. Pretty weird to think about. And that means, that gives her really easy hit confirms. Really easy hit confirms. Stuff like that. Sakura can hit confirm for days, which is appropriate because she could in alpha. It's 3 frames, this is 3 frames, they're both 3 frames. And they're both, like, plus a lot. So in general, like, these are just super spammable normals if they're actually in range to hit. And she can really, really easily just threaten the walk and throw. Her walk speed is, like, it's not as good as Ryu's, but it's still, like, you know, good enough. It's about normal. Her backwards walk speed, I think, is a little bit lower. Walks a little slowly backwards. Stand short, also 3 frames. Even at absolute max range, still 3 frames. The entire hitbox comes out at the same time. It goes really, 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 really far for a 3-frame normal. Actually, the farthest of all of Sakura's normals. And it converts into uppercut even at the absolute max range. Even if you hit a poke with it. So, in general, it's just a really good... Especially to end combos, because Sakura will often be, like, plus 4 and kind of far away. That's a very common situation for Sakura. And the far short will just... Sand Light Punch is plus 7, Crouch Light Punch is plus 6. We got confirmation from chat. So, you can just use this And it converts into a lot of her moves. It's not just DP. You can also convert the EX Tatsu on, like, most of the cast. So that's, like, a really nice little thing she has, where she can just get, like, really, 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 really far confirms. Etc., etc. And her low short chains into itself. It's +3. It's a 3-frame normal as well. So all of her lights are 3-frame normals. And there's no range dependency on any of them. If you're really precise, you can link a crouch short into another crouch short. It's a 1-frame link. And then you can cancel it, I guess. That's almost never a thing. It doesn't really matter. But it is possible. You get it? I don't think you did. It's hard. And it's also useless. Anyway. You can easily chain into jab, and jab has a lot more frame data. So it's very common with Sakura to see combos like, something like that. Really common. Or, like, this is a really common one. Something like that. It's really... Her combos just work very naturally. She's got really good frame advantage on, like, everything. So it's just, like, you can easily link into a lot of different stuff. I think that's a 3-frame link. The crouch jab and the crouch fierce. So, like, it's really not difficult. And stab jab is, like, a 4-frame link. So really, it's a 3-frame link is already basically an undroppable combo, unless like online is really bad. Let's see. Oh, her forward walk speed is better than Ryu's. I was looking at it; it didn't look as good. Is it actually better? Damn.
Feels better.
Her back walk speed is worse than Ryu's. Let's see here. Close stand strong is also a 3-frame normal. You don't really see this one that much because it's kind of outclassed by her close fierce, which is also a 3-frame normal. I don't really ever see close strong. I'm not gonna talk about close strong. It's kind of like I'm not gonna.
It's pretty good on counter hit.
Good on counter hit. Yeah, that makes sense. Probably it's better frame data than close fierce. That's pretty cool. I've never even heard of that. Fear focus for me. Oh fuck, Sakura! All right, let me try that again. Sakura! Oh, sorry. I was just mashing. I was mashing out of anger and fear. Okay, Sakura gets really small for her focus attack. Actually smaller than she is when she's crouching. No, I can't. Not in online training. Yeah, it's not a feature. You could hit stand roundhouse, I guess. It's like... Oh, close to stand roundhouse is even good. I forgot, that has good frame data. Shit, dude! Fucking all of her normals have good frame data. I can't counter hit any. Her overhead. Didn't combo it. If that works, I'm impressed. Ooh, look at that. Beautiful. All right, let me try converting. Oh, damn it. That was the weirdest confirm I could have possibly gone for. And I didn't even get the link. That was what I was going for. Or like EXDP or regular DP. All right, the cool thing about Sakura, Far Fierce. No, we'll get to Far Fierce in a second. Okay, so this gets lots of frame advantage on counter hit. Or rather, it just has good frame advantage in general. I don't think you can... Oh, that just works, huh? Wow, that's actually really cool. I was about to say, I don't think you can link conventional shit out of it, but I guess you can. Okay. Neat. That has good frame data. Didn't know that. You never see Sakura's use that much, because she's got really stupid combos, what we'll get to, that kind of ignore stuff like that. Low strong, you can link into it. It's not usually used. Close fierce is actually fast. I mean, crouch fierce is actually faster. But low strong goes a little bit farther, which makes it slightly better as a counter poke. But you can link into it. You can do combos like that. It's like not even a hard combo. I think it's 2 frames. And sometimes Sakura's do stuff like that. Like after a cross up, I think this one always works. But I think low strong always works. So you can do stuff like that. But you can just use low forward there. So like that would be what you would normally do. So you don't normally see crouch strong that much. But it is good as a counter poke, and you can link into it. And it's sometimes good to link into. Oh yeah, far strong. It cancels, doesn't it? Yeah. Like Ryu. But Sakura's far fierce cancels too, so like even better. Again, it's outclassed by her fierce. Her fierce is just so good that like you don't need strong, you know what I mean? Like the close strong is outclassed by the close fierce, the far strong is outclassed by the far fierce. I think the far strong comes out faster than the far fierce does. Oh yeah, that's a really easy link too, but so is stand fierce, so you know. But it's just because everything's 3 frames. She's got 7 3-frame normals. Let's see here. Stand forward is a decent counter poke. It goes pretty far. It's not as good as her stand roundhouse, which we'll talk about in a second, but you can use it to counter poke some stuff. I think it's situationally anti-airs, but it's not that good. It's outclassed by her crouch fierce. But I think Sakura's jump roundhouse is really hard to beat, so like... Okay. Looking pretty good. Maybe not so good. Not so good. I got counter hit, though. That means I didn't get it out in time. Yeah, I would use Crouch Fierce every day for Sakura. It's just better. I was a little early there. Okay, anyway. Close medium kick is actually a really, 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 really important move. I'll get to EX Tatsu soon. Let me actually bring that up now. Crouch medium kick into Tatsu is bad, and you shouldn't do that combo. And I'm sorry that I just did it. I, like, forgot that it was bad. Anyway, close medium kick is kind of like Ryu's close medium kick in that it actually puts you inside the opponent. So let's say I have just, like, stand fierce like Tatsu. I'm, like, this far away. I can't get a close fierce. It's, like, too far. It's, like, a far fierce. But if I do stand medium kick like Tatsu, I'm actually close enough to get a close fierce. And that's a really big deal because close fierce is fast enough to link and far fierce is not. So if I'm just doing combos like this, I'm too far apart. Like, even though I'm doing, like, combos like this, I think I'm too far apart, yeah. I need the close four to put me inside, like, Sakura's push box, which allows the Tatsu to recover really close to the opponent to go for Sakura's kind of more ideal combos.
That's not necessarily...
Yeah, you can start with just raw Tatsu, too. And
well,
it depends on the...
90% of the... Go ahead.
It depends on the opponent's body as well.
Yeah, 90% of the time that's true, but she has a lot of setups on a lot of different characters that make the light Tatsu hit me.
Yeah, you can get weird connects. I actually put a video up on that just recently. You can get weird deep connects of light Tatsu that give you lots of extra frame advantage. But I'm pretty sure that close medium kick, light Tatsu, close fierce works on all characters. If it's not everyone, it's very nearly everyone. And that's a really high damage combo starter. That's like...
Doesn't work on DiCaprio.
Maybe not Kami too either then. But that's just like, you know, that's 335 for one bar, which is, you know, pretty good. Sakura gets really high damage. That's like the thing, you wouldn't expect that about Sakura. You see this little girl, you see it like a schoolgirl. You wouldn't think her gimmick is that her movement is not that good and her damage is insanely high. That's like a fucking grappler. But that's how Sakura works. Her control of the ground is a little bit limited. Her normals are really good, but they're just so short range. But then when she actually gets, like, punishes, or, like, you know, she's got amazing counter hit setups and stuff like that, a decent mix-up just by frame traps. She's got basically the best frame traps in the game. Not the best, but, like, top five. That just enable to get these random hits, and when she gets these random hits, she just does a fuck ton of damage. But we'll get to that in a minute. What was I saying? Far forward, weird anti-air. Crouch forward is really good. It's, like, five frames. It's, like, as almost... I think it's, like, the same range as Ryu's. The hitbox is a little bit taller, which usually doesn't matter. At absolutely max range, it still combos into uppercut, which is a really big deal. It's like crouch forward. Even if you like counterpoke with it, you can just get these converts into uppercut. And it ends up doing... You just have really good control of the ground by merit of that. You can empty cancel it really easily. You can do, like, stuff like that. And just if the opponent happens to walk into it, they walk into the low forward, and then the SPD comes out. Really common. She's got really good... By merit of the DP, she's got really good empty canceling options. And that works with EX Tatsu as well, but not as well. DP is kind of better at it, but Tatsu is more rewarding. But this is just a really good low poke, and low poke, you know, low forward, it's not quite as good as, like, Ken's low forward. You can't convert out of it at max range like you can with other shadows, except for that DP, which, again, is only really, you can't, like, hit confirm that unless it's an empty cancel. So you can't just do, like, low forward fireball like you can with other shadows. That works. I think you have to use EX or do a close fierce. I think you're only plus 3 on FADC regular DP. I think you're only plus 3 there. That's really good. But you can't just use it like a safe poke. Like, you can do that, but it's not a combo. Except, I think, really close. So, even though it's a really good low forward, even though it's theoretically as good a low forward as Ryu's, the fact that you can't really convert the same way safely at max range means it's not as good as a low forward as Ryu's, just because it doesn't work with their special moves as well. Pepapulo, confirming plus 3. Nice, nice arc, nice coward copter. Close fierce is 3 frames. She's got a fucking shit ton of 3 frame normals. This is the only 3 frame close normal in the game, I think. Can't immediately think of another one. There's a couple 4 frame close normals. But this is a 3 frame close normal. And that's really good because she's got stuff like low short stand fierce, which already is a combo. It's a one-frame combo, but it's a combo. And if the opponent, that's like, it's neutral, okay? Minus, crouch short is neutral on block. So if the opponent hits the earliest possible close jab, crouch jab, That'll be a trade. And a trade with a light normal and a heavy normal usually results in a trade combo. Oh. This is hard to time, isn't it? Let's try and get that jab.
I'm mashing the hell out of it.
We both need to hit the same frame, but we don't need to be frame perfect. You do it on me. No, because then you'll have to get the convert too. But the point is, if you trade the light normal with that heavy normal, it gets so much extra frame advantage, and Sakura recovers so fast. Most characters only have... They can only trade with a 3-frame normal. And most characters, if they even have a 3-frame normal at all, it's going to be a fucking light normal. So she's basically guaranteed to trade with the light normal. And if you get trade stand fierce, you can combo like low 4 or DP, or like light Tatsu, or stuff like that. You've got a lot of stuff you can do there. Yeah, for the most part, you can't link out of close fierce. I think only on counter hit. But you don't really need to because of the way that light Tatsu works. Let's see here. Okay, I guess I'll try it. Nah, it doesn't look practical. Yeah. It's pushing out too far. Anyway. It's just a really good combo tool because it's so fast. It's 3 frames. It's really good for fishing for counter hits because she's got safe special moves. Like, that's 100% safe to go for. And, if it happens to work, you can convert out of it on reaction, and it's a frame cap. So it's just like, wow, that's really hard to deal with. Or like stuff like that. Walk-in stand fierce, or like walk-in throw is a really tricky thing, just because close stand fierce is so, like, it comes out so quickly, and it's safe. And you can cancel into stuff that's safe. And it's a true block string, and it, like, does chip damage. So all in all, it's just really good. But again, you have to actually get in with Sakura to use tools like that. And most of the characters that she can get in easily on are just as good in as she is. But I feel like Sakura is actually a pretty... I'm pretty sure close hard punch until light Tatsu is a true string. I'm like not 100%, but I'm like nearly 100%. Try holding up after you block the fierce. Yeah, true string. It would hit if it wasn't a true string. Let's see here. Far fierce cancels. It's kind of cool. It doesn't convert into a whole lot of stuff. The hit stun is really long, but the range is really particular. I think you can get... It's actually her strongest cancel, but you don't normally use it because of, like, other stuff. But, like, you can do, like, let's say if you're focusing, I could get, like, a Far Fierce into a DP or something like that, and that's a really high damage anti-focus. There's very specific... You can link into Far Fierce, too, in some situations, and I guess it's quite good damage. And ever since they buffed EX Fireball, EX Fireball combos from all ranges, and that does pretty good damage, too. Sakura's EX Fireball is really good now. It's really good for some stuff. Yeah, that works into Ultra, too. You almost never see that combo. It's like there's other combos. Sakura, all the stuff that would be good on other characters, Sakura doesn't need it because her EX Tatsu is so good. But like, it's kind of cool that stuff like that works. And that works even meterless in the corner. I shouldn't say meterless, it works for one bar, which is exactly the same price as EX Tatsu, which does more damage. I don't think it actually does anything. Does it increase damage to charge on EX one? I guess it does.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Neat.
Also makes it go a lot faster.
I think it already goes faster. No, I think it slows it down now.
Oh,
it used to make it go faster, but like the thing is, like they changed the speed of EX Fireball, so now it's really quick. Anyway, let's talk about other shit first. Where are we? Far Fierce? Crouch Fierce. This is a 4-frame normal, not quite 3. The damage is really good, I guess, for Sakura. Sakura's damage isn't that high. It's only 80. Oh, it's 90 that time. What the hell? Are those two separate hitboxes? It might do less damage anti-air. Fuck, I'm doing it too early. That was 100 on counter hit. So that was 80! It has 80 as an anti-air hitbox, and then 90 as a deep hitbox. I didn't know that, that's kinda cool. Two separate hitboxes. It's so small, you wouldn't think it would have two separate hitboxes. If you time it right, it's a true blue anti-air. It's almost impossible to beat. It's one of the best anti-air normals in the game. Really easy to make it go the other direction with a walk under or something like that. Really easy to get it to beat most air normals. And it's super fast. It's like 4 frames. It's really quick. It's the same speed as Ryu's. It's not as tall as Ryu's, though. But it tends to trade less.
Wake-up reversal.
It actually sadly is. Sadly, Sakura's normals are so fast you can use them on wake-up to some degree. Let me see here. It's like its main use is as an anti-air, but also it's one of the normals that works into Tatsu, light Tatsu. And that's really important for our combos. And linking into it in general is just really good. I thought that always worked. I guess that combo is kind of weird. Sakura has kind of a weird hitbox, doesn't she? Her box. But it, Sakura's... I was going to say, Sakura's fierce normals are a little bit weaker than other characters. She doesn't have anything above 100 except, like, Far Fierce and Far Roundhouse. Close Fierce is only 90. Close Fierce is only 90. Anyway. That's like a common combo tool, and it's common for anti-airs. Those are like the two main purposes. Might do some other stuff too, I don't think so. Stamina House is the closest thing she has to a poke, besides Crouch Medium Kick. It's a lot more general use than her Crouch Medium Kick. You just hit it. There's no skill to it. Just do it when the opponent's close enough to get hit by it. It's pretty good. A lot of characters have a hard time with it. Some characters, like, less so, I guess. But the frame data is good. It comes out really fast. Recovers really fast. The damage is pretty good for Sakura. There's no mix-up to it. It's just block it, you know. But it can counterpoke some stuff pretty easily. It looks like it'd be really good for counterpoking lows, but I think it's only okay. Yeah, look at that. I'm carving myself into it. It's not even good for counterpoking lows. but it sure looks like it would be good. But it's just a general poke. That's just the end of it. There's nothing to say about this button except that it's actually a really good button. You should hit it all the time. Doesn't even interact. Close run house, you almost never see. It looks like it'd be a really good anti-air, but close fierce is a really good anti-air too, so usually you wouldn't bother with close run house. It does do slightly higher damage, I guess, and it combos into red focus, I suppose. But I think they all do, yeah. So that's not usually a huge issue. It's the highest damage cancel into super, but that's almost never an issue because you'd rather get DP. This doesn't super, it only super cancels, it doesn't special cancel. So you could do something like that. That actually is probably pretty strong, 500. But you would do something else.
Yeah, but the
you would
yeah,
do like. Yeah. That would probably do more. Yeah, 526. Anyway, it's really slow, but it's her one poke. Summation of Stam Run House. It's really slow, but it's her one poke. It's not even slow. It's like pretty fast for a poke. It's pretty slow for Sakura. Sakura is just really quick. So having a single slow tool is just kind of weird. And her Crouch Roundhouse is pretty much exactly the same thing, but goes lower. It's fast enough to combo into. Its poke range is really high. I think the damage is only 90. Is that a safe jump? I don't think she has a safe jump. There it is. I don't think that's a safe jump. Yeah. She's not Ryu. You could probably time a safe jump there, though, because she recovers before the opponent. Like, you just have to manually time it. That's the problem. But it goes really far, so you can get some stuff, like even at max range, you can get like a sweep combo.
I just realized we didn't talk about Geef's throat.
Geef's throat? What?
His normal throw.
Oh, I talked about his normal throw for like 10 seconds. Maybe like looking at chat or something. I just said it was less risky. But are there setups after it? Because if there are setups after it, I don't even know them.
I think there's a couple.
Oh, well, fuck it. We're in the soccer tutorial now. medium DP jump is a safe jump, according to chat. That's a safe jump.
Oh, wow.
But for quick stand. For quick stand is a problem. Because they might not quick stand.
Yeah.
But that's still really good. I didn't know that. That's interesting. Safe jumps are less of a relevant thing these days. But most people will quick stand there. So that's actually a good tool. You would have to know not to quick stand there. Let's see here. Where was I on normals? I guess I just completed them, right? She's only got one command normal, I think, which is the overhead. It's an overhead. It's about as bad as overheads get, except for range, which is above average. The damage is not that good. It's fine. 80 is fine. It's actually quite high for an overhead, I guess. It goes super far. It goes, like, really, really far. The frame data is crap. It's pretty slow for a overhead, and it recovers pretty slowly. It's like -3 or -4 even on hit. Or even on block, I should say. Or fuck. I'm pretty sure it's like neutral and then goes to like -4. Something like that. Yeah, you obviously can salvage it if they don't quick stand. But it's just a really far overhead. But it's reactable. It's like slowish. It's slow enough to react to. But it's really good because she's got some setups where, like the really common one, the Uryo setup, you have the opponent knocked down and then you have like a meaty EX fireball going. And then while they're blocking the meaty EX fireball, I mean, charged fireball. You can snag an overhead or snag a low in there, something like that, and it's kind of harder to see and react to. But, like, it's good that she has it, but it's, like, compared to other overheads, it's, like, only lackluster. It's only okay.
She does have some silly setups where...
Yeah, you can... There's actually a really crazy setup where you can get a level 2 fireball over the opponent, and then overhead them, and then they get pushed into the level 2 fireball, and then you can combo a low forward. So you can combo out of overhead... And, like, I don't know the setup, but I know that there's a setup that actually does something like that. And it's really crazy when you see it.
I think you have to, like,
I don't think you need enough ADC for that setup. I think it is mid-screen only, because you have to push them into a fireball. But I forget how it goes, but it's like a level two fireball. And then, I forget. It's really weird.
I don't know.
Her conversions, yeah, user unknown in the chat. Her conversions are so good off of lows that the fact that she has an overhead is just strong. Her low conversions are just super safe and just do, like, tons of damage. Alright, hold on. It's like that. Fuck, that's not an Atoshi. I don't know if I'll be able to replicate this. Oh, I tried to. You got a crouch block, don't forget. Oh, fuck. Here I come. Ah. I don't know. It must be really precise. It could even have been removed for all I know. It might just be combo video material. But all the relative timings are really interesting there. Oh, that was almost it. I feel like that was close. Pushes the opponent into the fireball and then the left forward combos. It's like a super weird setup. Anyway, let's talk about her air normals, I guess. Let me double check that she doesn't have another ground command normal. I don't think she does. Just flower kick. So she's got the jumper house, which is really, really, really long. She's got like a really long leg there. The damage is about normal. You can use it to instant overhead, which is neat. So you can do like I could do like a fuzzy guard setup on you, even though you're like Sakura. Do something like that. I think that works. You gotta block, then, because I'll be at a weird range if you don't block. That actually didn't work. It would work if I jump forward, I think. Maybe not. It would work well on a taller character than Sakura. But Sakura is short. It might be my timing.
Nah.
Can't get it to work. Neutral jump roundhouse works really well as a instant overhead. That one like is 100% success rate. Anyway, that goes really far, so it hits the opponent sooner than they might be expecting. And combined with that, neutral jump jump forward fierce, goes almost no range at all. So on some anti-air normals, you can kind of get a mix-up between those two. It doesn't work nearly as well as it used to because she used to have a recessed hurt box during jump fierce, but they took that out because it was too stupid.
It was dumb.
But she can still kind of like mess up the opponent's anti-air timing by doing an early jump runout or a late jump fierce. But for the most part, that's like not even a mix-up for almost the whole cast. Let's see here. Apart from that, she's got jump strong, which is a pretty good air-to-air. Probably your best hope of an air-to-air with Sakura. Does decent damage, it's 80, I think. Jump jab is probably better just from a speed issue, actually. But, you know, not rewarding. Jump medium kick is her cross-up. It's actually like it's a fine cross-up. It's not great, it's not terrible. It's like Ryu's. It's pretty much exactly the same as Ryu's. Her jump arc is kind of wide, which means it's somewhat deep. It's kind of harder to hit than other characters, but it's like good enough. It's like still good. Still a really good over. Oh yeah, her crouch medium kick has low profile frames. Forgot about that.
Her fierce crosses up.
Oh, her fierce has a very, very particular cross-up hitbox. It's better than most weird ones. It's like easier to cross-up with that than most funky cross-ups. Nice anti-air fierce. Anti-air fierce is actually a very real thing for her and Kami. They're really good for like a walk under cross, like a cross under anti-air. That's like her best hope at a cross under anti-air. But she can low profile stuff like a guy elbow drop with like low forward, and that's really useful. Let's see here. That's pretty much it for air normals. Jump short and jump jab you almost never see. I think jump short's a cross up too actually, or it was an alpha. I don't think it is in this game.
It is.
Oh, it still is. So that's actually kind of useful because the opponent recovers a little faster than they're probably expecting. So you could do stuff like that. I was actually too fast. On block, that would work, though. Little stuff like that is tricky. Every now and then, a lot of high-level players like the really low, the really short. I think it's probably you have a little bit less vulnerability to use it like that. But, you know, she's got like two cross-ups then, which is pretty nice. Variety is more useful than anything else. That's pretty much it for our normals, right? Oh yeah, neutral jump normals. Neutral jump roundhouse is probably her best hope. She doesn't really have... That's probably neutral jump medium kick. It's her best anti-air. Neutral jump normal. But that's not really a huge issue for most characters. Neutral jump roundhouse goes super far down, which is really important
jump
for...
medium kick again?
Oh, look at that!
Let's have a cross-up.
Fucking sick! I wouldn't even thought to test that. A cross-up neutral jump. Akuma has that too.
Ryu doesn't have one.
Yeah, Ryu doesn't have one. I tested that when I found out Akuma did, because I thought it'd be the same normal, but it's not. Little subtle differences. It's really crazy that Capcom, you have two identical normals on two different characters, and then they've just got completely different hitboxes. It's like Capcom. I mean, yeah, like it's like tricky. I mean, I wish that Ryu had it, but it's neat that Capcom like cared enough to make every character individually designed. They did very little cutting and pasting. Yeah, Faye has Ninja Jump Roundhouse cross up. That's huge. A lot of I shouldn't say a lot, but there's a couple characters with the really big Ninja Jump Roundhouses. They go both ways. And then T-Hawk and I think Hakan have Ninja Jump cross ups that are really good. Oh yeah, there's a. No, that's Kami who does that. It's the same animation, so I got confused. Kami has a cute little setup with that, but I don't think Sakura does.
And this normal, too, is really...
What does that normal do?
It's so after in the corner.
Okay.
You get a throw. Depending on if they do, or it might not be a throw. If they do, there's a setup if you do, delayed wake up or not. If you don't do the delayed wake up, that'll hit. If you see the delayed wake up, you jump again and you get another safe jump.
Interesting. Very interesting.
It's really stupid. But it's really good.
I know that is less damage than every other light normal I've ever seen in the entire like air game. It's 30. That's really weird. Most air light normals do 50. It's really weird that's 30. That's really low. That's very odd. Her jump jab is 50. The jump short for the they're both 30. That's really low. Anyway, let's talk about our special moves, I suppose. Let's talk about Shoken. Why not Shoken? It's her DP. Contrary to the fact that it's an uppercut in a Street Fighter game, it's actually not invincible at all and not particularly fast. I think the light one is pretty fast. It's like it's like 3 or 4 frames. It's actually surprisingly quick. But it's not invincible. And the medium one and the hard one are also not invincible. They do have pretty good hitboxes. The first hits go really far forward, and the later hits go really far up. So I'm not going to say you can't anti-air with them. You actually can. And they have juggle potential on most of the hits of the back hits. So oftentimes, like, Sakura's will do stuff like... This is really good on some characters. You'll throw a fireball, and if they jump on reaction to the fireball, you can get, like, a double uppercut going. And the damage is crap, but it's got the corner carry. It is free damage. You know, you get the knockdown set up, you get meter.
After one, I think you can actually go two.
Light is 7 frames? I thought, hold on. I thought that was, no. Never mind. Okay, so they're all slow as fuck. Let me see here. You can use them, the medium one, the light one into medium combos inherently, even on a standing opponent. And I think that works on the whole cast, you're very close to it. And they all combo from like all ranges, even after light normals. They're all fast enough to combo after light normals, just inherently. And for that reason, you pretty much always go into the heavy one. Unless, well, I mean, they're all unsafe, so you might as well go into the heavy one, and you might as well hit confirm it. But you get that really easy full screen conversions, I should say. And, they do knock down, which is nice, because Sakura's Tatsus don't knock down, and her fireball doesn't knock down. So, you know, they're like the stereotypical Ender. They do quite good damage. Hard is 155, which is actually, like, almost the damage of Ryu's. But you can't really use them to anti-air, so they're just combo Enders. That's, like, the entirety of it. They're just combo Enders. You can use them to anti-air to a very limited degree. They do break armor, which is pretty good, because they hit reasonably fast. So, like, if you focus for me. If I was doing something like this. They break armor. Well, fuck. They break armor by being merit of multi-hit. That's quite common. But normally you see Tatsu combos there because Tatsus inherently break armor, so you beat even red focus. Hold on. Let's see here. What about I can't think of anything for those. Just EX, I guess. 6, 7, 12 for the 3 speeds.
Oh yeah.
I should have mentioned that. That's important. They all set up her ultra. Oh, and that's actually really important. The harder the version, the more hits hit midair, and thus the more juggle points you use up. So if you do the hard one, you end up using a lot of your hits of ultra too. But it still works. I missed it. But the light one is really easy, and you actually get, like, I think the full ultra too. So it's a meterless ultra two conversion in the corners. And that's really important because Sakura has crazy corner carry. So, like, she'll often get the opponent in the corner. And then she can just land her ultra off of any confirm.
That even works mid-screen.
It's a mid-air connect on mid-screen, I think. You have to do stuff like, you see, this crap. But that's not even worth the damage. I actually lowered my damage by doing that. There's a weird little thing about that, that I should actually talk about right now. You gotta, the up one's a lot faster than the straight one. So this is a weird little thing. The damage is, it's 90, then 15 for that, for the light one. It's only two hits. And the 90 has, if you get the 90, it increases the damage of that combo. So that's really common in the corner. You try and do, this actually increases the damage. I thought it was just for meter build, but it actually increases the overall damage. You get the juggle into the first hit, which is the 90, and then it still juggles into ultra. So let me actually get some raw damage values going. I've got ultra double. But like, here's my ultra up. It's going to be more extreme because I've got ultra double. But it's still going to show. 324 versus... Ta-ta. 392. Normally that wouldn't be as big of a difference. Oh, you can't combo medium punch into ultra 2. Only light, hard, and EX. That's hilarious. I've never actually seen EX used like that, but that's actually really cool. I imagine that's corner only. They're all corner only. That didn't look good.
Okay.
How interesting. Okay. Anyway. That's one of the uses of them, is that you can use them in juggles like that. I forgot about that. And then you can also use them to FADC. That's actually really... I forgot about that. That's really specific. There's a lot of uses for this move. I honestly, like, I should have given it more thought. If you FADC... FADC is the first three hits. And the third hit on FADC, and I think also the second hit on FADC. Maybe the first, I don't know. But definitely the third, and the third's the one you want to use because it's the most damage. It's all unscaled damage to get all the hits, so you might as well get them all. But it's plus three. So if you're really precise, you can get a close fierce there. If you're good. And this is hard. I blinked it too, I got it. I got the blink. Not enough though. It's a lot easier for EX. Ah! Something like that. That already did a lot of damage. I did like a really high damage convert though. I hit like 2-1 frame links in that combo, that was cool. You can like convert any uppercut into something like that. Normally you'll just go straight into Stand Fierce into EX and Tatsu, but that doesn't add that much damage. So like you don't see people do that often. But it's kind of good because if you get something like that, it's really hard to get an EX Tatsu after a confirm like that. It's just way too far to get an EX Tatsu. But you can do DP, FADC, like Stand Fierce EX Tatsu, and that'll suddenly get a really good conversion. And it's quite common to get Stand Chab low board in the range from Sakura. Oh yeah, you can do that too. And that gets the high damage version too. So that's actually worth going for. I forgot about that. But you would do something else there. You would do, unless you had no bar, and then that would be what you would do. Here we go. I did the straight one. Anyway, that's pretty much all I got for a normal Shoken. EX is a completely different deal. It's not very fast at all, so you can safe jump it without too much trouble. And it also doesn't work properly on jumping opponents, but it's invincible, and it has quite a lot of juggle potential, which is usually irrelevant. And you can FADC it, I think, on four separate occasions, I think. It's a shit ton of hits, it's a shit ton of damage, and on FADC it's actually plus four, which is quite a lot, which means you can comfortably combo out of it. Oh, that's what I'm talking about for the anti-air, for the juggle. It's kind of picky. That's quite common from Sakura players. That's all your bar, though, so, you know, enjoy it. You're actually plus four there, so you can actually combo up close forward, and then from there you can do light Tatsu and then Stand Fierce, and that ends up doing a fuck ton of damage. That's actually Sakura's highest damage starter, but it sure uses up all your meter. It's also very precise. Unfortunately, Sakura, you have to hit a lot of links in order to play Sakura, and you can just go for two frame links in most instances, but she really becomes deadly when you go for the one framers. Sakura's a pretty good character to learn blinks on. She's also very simple. Sakura's a very simple character to play. She's not too hard, but, you know, her advanced game is really... Was that a car throw?
That's just short.
It's just you moving forward. I believed for a second, dude.
Well, no, I'm carring short.
Oh, essentially. Yeah, wow, that is a car throw. It's a really shitty one. I didn't think she had one. Interesting. I think it's exactly plus four. I'm like nearly certain it's plus four because it's hard as fuck to get the close forward link. For the record, there's two separate hits you can FADC after the second DP. That was the first one after the uppercut. See the first uppercut resolved, and then I FADC the first hit after it. That's the you can do those three hits. That's it. It's like the second uppercut. It's like the first, second, or third hit of the second uppercut. You can FADC, and you want to get as many of them as possible. So you want to get the third hit. Oh, don't kill me. Something like that. I'm actually hitting my links hella good. Hella well. That was cool. Anyway, you can get conversions out of EXDP. The thing is, it's invincible, and it's invincible for a really fucking long time. Throw me a fireball. Hey, it goes really far, and it's invincible for that whole time. So you can use it to anti-fireball to some degree. And you can use it to just blow through pokes and stuff like that. It's really easy to buffer a shoryuken motion while doing a forward walk. You do a standing shoryuken motion, which is forward, down, forward, forward. You can just totally just walk forward EXDP with no trouble. And that's just really, like, it's, again, very similar to EX Green Hand from Geef. It's a really easy way to turn a game around. Because it's invincible for a long time, and you can just convert a ton of damage out of it on hit. Apart from that, that's pretty much all EXDP is good for. Just invincibility. I see it a lot of times after, like, a neutral jump, they end in, like, lane. Get that. I thought you could FADC the first one. The first uppercut. You never would, but I thought you could. That's like a swag combo. I think that actually works. But it might be like corner only, or you have to back up. There you go. Cool. Swag combo. Ruined most of your own juggle potential. That was cool, I've never seen that. Anyway. Let's talk about Fireball, I guess. Sakura's Fireball is not Ruse. If you use it like Ruse, you'll die. It's better than having no Fireball, anyway. But the startup is really poor. Especially if you charge it. And the recovery is not even that good. So it ends up not being that good of a fireball. It's also very slow, which is normally good for a fireball. Nice taunt.
Oh, come on.
I think I have the default. Is that the default? Fucking, it's good to change up your taunts here and there. What was I saying? The fireball, you can't chase in the slow fireball, which nullifies the use of it being slow. I guess you can if you FADC it, but they dissipate, so it's really not that useful. And then, if you charge it a little bit, it does more damage, but it's almost impossible to land a charged fireball. There's one exception that's used all the time. But for the most part, charging a fireball is just useless. It does delay it, which is sometimes useful. Like if the opponent jumps on reaction to you charging a fireball and then they like land on a heavy one or something. That could happen. Is that one of them? Maybe not. Sakura is so cute. I think the Stand Fierce will hit. There are a lot of taunts that change hitboxes.
I play for keeps.
Oh, I can't even get a close normal.
Wow.
I can't reach her push box. She's covering up the space to her push box.
I play for keeps.
Wow.
Amazing. That's cool. There are a lot of taunts that change hurtboxes, and they're all funny when they happen. That's arguably the best taunt Sakura has for that reason. Anyway. Where was I? If they jump on reaction to a fireball, you can theoretically make them land on a bigger fireball. And they do more damage. And you can combo out of that, I think, into like a medium DP or something. If theoretically you actually manage to get it. Yeah. Snag on 15 damage there. Charging fireballs is usually irrelevant, but I've already been doing it, but just like the one time that you actually do it is after a 2-hit Sakura Otoshi, it's a hard knockdown. And then you can charge a meaty hard fireball. I did a little early there, because, I was scared about not being in the corner. Sakura Otoshi is a really interesting move. We'll talk about it in a second. But you have to block this, and then there's a little mix-up there, because Sakura can go for an overhead, she can go for a low, she can go for, like, a frame trap after you recover from it, she can throw you. It's a bunch of scary stuff she can do. And, if it actually hits, you can actually combo out of it. And that's, like, a really common thing. Like, if for some bizarre reason you don't try and, like block. That's a frame trap there. That was me trading with light normal. I could have comboed out of that. But that's really common, just to get that meaty fireball going. Normally, mid-screen, it's like 50-50 with Sakura. Some people just complete the Sakura Otoshi, and some people do the like the two and then the charge. In the corner, everyone does the charge because the Sakura Toshi is really shitty in the corner. Let's talk about the Sakura Toshi right now. It gets it crosses up after three hits in the corner. Fuck.
It's worth noting that after the Otoshi, the timing to do that, the backdash is right when they land, instead of any earlier or any later, otherwise the setup won't work.
So yeah, yeah. You can use the opponent's landing time as a timing. As soon as you see them hit the ground, backdash, fireball. I was really slow on the fireball. but that's like the timing. Backdash as they land, fireball, full charge as soon as the backdash ends. But Sakura Otoshi on a cornered opponent is, whoa, that was a weird hit. I think all versions of Otoshi are the same. They're all overheads too. If you actually get all three hits, let me actually get all three hits. I like miss it on purpose. Like, it crosses up, and that cross up, there's nothing good to do here. There's like no way to like cross back over and like, you know, salvage the situation. It's better to just
That's
do two.
Not true.
Oh yeah, you've got something? Like a light Tatsu or something?
On a lot of characters, that will cross up.
Okay. That actually sounds pretty good then. If you can get a cross up, if you can get that Tatsu to connect, that would actually be like a really tricky setup. Okay, cool. Neat little thing. Sakura Toshi, it has, it's not, it doesn't track the opponent except the X. It just has a couple defined ranges. The recovery is fucking really long if you whiff it, so make sure that if you're going to whiff it, at least hit a button so that you don't have that ground recovery. You do not want her to have that ground recovery. Does it break armor? You got me all excited. There's only that one thing to do from it. It's got a demon flip motion, which makes you all excited. It's like, oh man, Sakura has a demon flip, but not really. It has basically two purposes. What?
Does EX break armor?
I don't think so. Yeah. Basically, it has two purposes. One of them is inside combos with the EX Tatsu. You get that's like your highest damage ender. The other purpose is much, much, much more impractical. If you're fighting a very heavy fireballing character, you can use EX to track the opponent and get a punish like that. And that does pretty good damage, but it's super risky because they could just anti-air you. You're betting a bar on a guess. You can't react to their fireball and do it. You have to predict the fireball and do it. So like, I wouldn't do this. But like, it's there, and I've seen that. I've seen people use that to effect. The fact that you have full screen presence is inherently useful, even if it's really bad full screen presence.
You can on Sagat and Hugo combo from.
Oh yeah, that was like a big thing in Cross Tekken. I forgot about that. You can get like a combo into the Sakura Toshi on grounded opponents.
It's really good, actually. You can just go straight into the medium.
That's actually kind of neat. Let's see here. That's pretty much it for Otoshi. There's not a whole lot to say. So the thing we've been dancing around is actually her best special move. Let's get to light last. First of all, hard Tatsu is normally just to... You can arc over a fireball with it, but it's so specific you'd never actually do it. But it actually does go over fireballs. And you can use that, like, predicting a fireball to kind of, like, just kind of get your way in. And the cool thing about all of her versions, medium less so than the others, I think. But the cool thing about all of her versions is they're actually safe. Medium might be, like, -3 or something, actually. Hard is, like, -1, I think. And light is neutral. And EX is, I think, +2. So, like, it's relatively riskless to throw out Tatsus. And they go pretty far, and they do good damage even if you don't get all the hits. And they even hit crouching opponents, and they do a good chip. You know, it's like, in general, like a very, not a very risky move. And they break armor. So, like, you know, it's, you don't really see people do hard Tatsu and footsies all that much, but it does, it's not terrible. You can complete combos with it. Most people would rather do uppercut, but you can complete combos with Tatsu if you want, like, you want to leave the opponent standing, and then get, like, a throw mix-up or something like that. Light kick, is it -1? I think it's neutral. I think it's just dead zero. But like the hard one, you can use it as a combo ender. I think it has a very small amount of juggle potential, but you never use it like that. Yeah, it's good damage, but I think the uppercut usually outclasses it. That's the problem. The uppercut is just generally a combo ender, a better combo ender. But that's safe. That's the important thing. That's a safe thing to go for, and the uppercut isn't. So like you can actually get like good safe pressure there. And that does quite a lot of chip too. The uppercut also does good chip. So Sakura has pretty nice chip options. I guess I'll show it off. Fuck. I need you to block something. Yeah, there's the chip of uppercut. I guess it's lower than you would think. And then the chip of Tatsu. It won't get all the connects on a crouching opponent. I did medium just to show off. Barb will lose a hit, lose all its hits. So yeah, you normally chip out with probably uppercut. Anyway.
They can cross up crouching opponent.
Oh yeah, yeah. There's a little bit of trickiness with that, but it's very precise and it's character specific. You can get like a cross up on one of the hits. I don't think her air Tatsu crosses up. I forgot about that. Her other special move.
It can cross up if you can get it wrong.
It's like the front hit that crosses up, right? It's not the back hit like Ryo can.
Yeah.
It's really.
I don't think it's a true cross up.
It's a weird little thing that she has.
Fake cross up.
So it's hard to do stuff like that on Sakura though. That looked good. That looked like it. I didn't try to block it though. I don't care. Medium Tatsu, you don't really see it all because it's outclassed by every other version. It also has the worst frame data of all of them, so just pretend it doesn't exist, I guess. It's probably alright for some stuff, but I don't know what that stuff is. Light Tatsu is king. Light Tatsu is the reason to use Sakura. It is one of the best special moves in the game. It's +4 on hit, neutral on block, does good chip damage, combos from everything. It doesn't combo from light normals. It's a shame. It'd be really good if it did. It would actually be insanely broken. But it's +4, and +4 combined with Sakura's amazing startup on all of her normals means that you can get some really stupid combos. The one I just did was stand forward, light Tatsu, stand fierce, light EX Tatsu, but actually it gets a lot dumber than that. Shit. You can, if your links are good, you can get some really crazy combos going that end up doing like a lot of damage. Yeah, Sakura, Sephiroth, help me with the, with the blocking. Yeah. You can do stuff like that, and that actually does a pretty insane amount of damage. I want to get like the damage value once. That's like the bread and butter. That's like the one frame link. That's really high damage with like very few actual links. That was 389. That's really respectable one bar damage. Sakura's damage is really high. But if you're good with the links, you can get even better than that. And I really want to get it just once, just to see the raw damage. There you go. 374. That actually did a little bit less. It got more meter anyway. If you're hot with the links, you can do cool stuff like that. Here's a really common. This is a swaggy one. This one does a fuck ton of damage. Oh shit. I tried. Crouch fierce into super. Oh yeah, you can't auto block that because it's low. It's actually a low super. Forgot about that. I'll give it another try. Hey, that wasn't even that strong. Sakura has some really high damage combos with that light Tatsu though. The point is, you can safely like frame trap into it and then just cancel into light Tatsu. And if you ever see a light Tatsu connect, all of a sudden, no difficulty, that's just stand short, and then you just get the conversion into like uppercut, into EX Tatsu, into anything. This is the bread and butter of Sakura's character. Nice link. You got the lose damage there. It's like impossible to get the gain damage this first hit of uppercut unless you're in the corner, or except against very specific opponents. We've been using EX Tatsu a whole lot. Nice FADC. Nice FADC DX Tatsu. That's actually, there's a little bit of wonkiness with that. I'll actually show it off in a second. You can do some swaggy stuff. Hold on. Let's just talk about like the, no, we'll talk about combos at the end of it. But just light Tatsu is very combo friendly, and we'll get to those combos in a minute. EX Tatsu, we've been using it a lot. Believe it or not, it's actually safe. It's +2. So not only is it safe, but Sakura gives you one frame before she's hitting you with one of her three frame normals. Or, you know, more if she chooses to. Basically, like she's at a really good situation after you block an EX Tatsu. Like, all of a sudden, you still have to contend with stand short or crouch short or walk and throw or something like that. Sakura has pretty good forward walk speed. All of a sudden, you have to deal with like this mix-up after you block that. If you block it, if it hits, it's actually like Sakura gets a full combo on you. And to make it even worse for you, good for Sakura, it's Fireball Invincible. You can actually use it like on reaction as a Fireball Punish. It tends to lose hits like that, but you get the conversion. You can land an Ultra maybe. And it's a one-bar conversion Ultra. And it works for all of her Ultras. I've been using up Fireball, which is the easiest one to land, requires no timing whatsoever. As a general rule, EX Tatsu, an immediate Ultra 1, I mean Ultra 2, in either direction, mid-screen, always works. So regardless, if I do the straight one, it's slower. So, like, She'll just fall into it, and the up one will just work. So you don't need to time that one at all. If it's in the corner, then you need to wait a little bit before you use it. But if you do the up one, it's pretty easy to time. And they're both, they do the same damage. You might be able to throw the up one immediately. Well, I wouldn't. Just wait a little bit for the fall.
Just wait if you really can't time it.
Oh yeah, whiff a jab, it'd be like. I guess the punch one is a little bit more consistent mid-screen, but I like never drop them, and I've never seen anyone drop them, so I don't think it matters that much. Ultra 1 is a little bit harder to land. Why are we talking about Ultras? We're talking about Ultra, EX Tatsu. Alright, whatever, let's just do it. Ultra 1 is a little bit harder to land, but it still works. It's, you have to, mid-screen, you have to walk in, or forward dash. Forward dash is a bit easier. And then, I actually mistimed it. I was a bit late. Cool combo. Ugh, nice motion. Baf with the fucking clean execution. I think that's it. That's like how you land it. Use the forward dash for timing and also to get close. But unfortunately in the corner, like, there's... You can still forward dash, I think, in the corner if you, like, really want to. But you just have to time it kind of precisely. You can whip a normal if you want. But it's not that hard to time. But I see Sakura drop it every now and then. It just sucks. Because you're punishable.
You don't have to dash.
Oh yeah, you can like, you can get a, I actually forgot about that, you can get fake connects to this shit. You can do like a really early one. That works on some characters. What I used to think you had to do was this. Hold on, time out. I thought you had to get like the whiff on the first hit and then connect the second. And that actually still plays out the animation. If you only get the third hit, I think it doesn't play out the animation. That was a cool connect. Anyway. There you go. I lost some damage there, though. You'd rather do the forward dash than the fucking use that to your timing.
Do quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, Ultra 1 is stronger than Ultra 2, but Ultra 2 has some setups that Ultra 1 doesn't work in. Like, after a light DP, you can land Ultra 2, but not Ultra 1. There aren't that many of those, though. For the most part, Sakura, most of her Ultra setups are just EX Tatsu, and in EX Tatsu, they'll both work. So, Sakura doesn't really mind that much which Ultra she picks, but Ultra 2 is arguably a little smidge better. That was cool. That was actually kind of neat. there's no mix-up, though. But that's still, like, kind of neat little reset pressure.
If it gets a counter combo out of it.
Oh yeah, EX Tatsu, the ending is a free juggle state, and a lot of people do stuff like this. Maybe, I kind of fucked it up. But you can do stuff like that, you can actually get like cross-ups and stuff. You can do like sneaky little resets. They're kind of easy to see, so a lot of people don't bother to go for them. And there's one where like you have to do an instant, my bad. You have to do like an instant jump around house or something like that, and then it lands on a really weird side. Nice. Very tricky. There's one that looks like this. I forget how it goes. It's like that, and then you can walk under. And it's actually really cool looking. I don't know. Maybe it's a dash as soon as you hit the ground. I don't remember. I actually don't remember. There's some trickiness there. Yeah, I think that's it. You can get some tricky resets there. The point is the free juggle state is actually just super useful as an ender. Normally you just end with Sakura Toshi. Oh yeah, that works. There's good combos that do that in cross Tekken. Sakura's really crazy in cross Tekken. Normally you just end with Otoshi, mid screen or corner, just because it does the most damage. And mid screen you can do two or three hits, corner you usually do two, and then get the meaty fireball because that does the same damage as the third one anyway. If you have Ultra, you can just end it with Ultra. If you have, like, a bunch of bar but don't have Ultra, I don't think there's a really good way to do a lot of damage. If you, like, I think Otoshi's just the best ender if you have meter or if you don't. I don't think you can follow up into super or anything like that. Well, fucking, you can't comp follow up into super because you're burning a bar to do it. But I don't think, like, EX DP does any sort of meaningful damage or anything like that. Useless. You can do another EX Tatsu even. Oh, and Sephiroth just demonstrated it, but, you can FADC the last hit, but it's literally, you would never, ever, ever do it. It's already safe. It already leads to Ultra. But, like, for whatever reason, you can't cancel with a super because you're burning a bar. I don't know why the fuck they made it FADCable, but you can FADC it.
I can show you a good reason.
Oh, yeah? Impress me. I mean...
No one's going to expect that.
No one's going to tech that throw. I got to admit, you wouldn't burn three bars for it, though. Or even two if you just, you know, we're going to talk to anyway. You can do like this, though. Make it really easy to combo an Ultra 1. You could do like, oh, sorry. Didn't want you blocking. Do like, that. That actually makes it harder. I can't think of a time you would ever do that. It's just not useful. You can do this. And then you can combo Ultra 2. That'd actually be a really swaggy way to kill the opponent. Never mind. That might be corner only, or it might not work at all. Unfortunately, the opponent falls really fast after level 2 focus. We're talking about stuff that's not even useful in any match. This is not stuff for a tutorial. Let's just get to her super and her ultras and then combos and we'll be done. Let's see here. Super is not conventionally super useful. If you don't have ultra, it's her max damage conversion. I already did the combo that most people do, which is just stand fierce, hard uppercut, and then you cancel the third hit into super. The canceling is a bit weird because you have to do it's double quarter circle back instead of forward, but it's really not that hard to buffer. I actually accidentally did it too fast. It is a perfect counter for focus. Stop. What the fuck is that? It is a perfect cancel. It is a perfect counter to focus. It does hit low, which is completely irrelevant against an opponent, better than like one PP. I can't think of it. Most of the time, it's just a combo ender. There's like nothing more to it than that. Oh, it does go through fireballs, but you wouldn't normally use it like that. But it does. Just for the record, throw me a fireball. Oh fuck, I wasn't ready. It's like pretty good at going through fireballs, actually. Not that good. That's too far. I'm never gonna land it like that. Whoa! Why wouldn't I just do that? Sakura's fireball is really slow, and this is better on fast fireballs. There you go. You wouldn't normally use it like that, but it's worth it to know that it does work. But normally you just EX Tatsu there. It's just a combo ender, and it doesn't combo after. It does combo after fireball, but you never do that, and it doesn't combo after Tatsu, because Tatsu doesn't super cancel. So you basically got to combo it after uppercut. Oh yeah, we didn't even talk about her other special move. There's not that much to say. EX, to the best of my knowledge, is completely useless. The normal one is almost useless. The only thing it does is alter her jump arc to make you jump farther, which is kind of useful. Like if you're fighting like certain characters with like anti-airs that go straight up and you can like Tatsu over their heads and then maybe whiff punish them, there's like a little bit of use, or like you'll hit them sooner than they're expecting. And it air to airs really well. I was gonna
admit. There is a difference between the normal and the EX. If you do like that, you gotta stop midway, but with EX.
I just want a coward cop there. Yeah, she Tatsus until she hits the ground. That's really cool. Permanent Tatsu. It'd be better if it hit on the back. Then it'd be like Oni. They need to fix that. That's like one of the worst EX moves in the game. It does knock down, and it is a juggle potential one scenario, so you can do like a... If you actually manage to get like a jump in Tatsu, you can juggle into an Ultra 2. I might have missed it. Yeah, but that works, which is kind of cool. And that's not even a super rare scenario, believe it or not. I think that's it. If they're trying to like low profile something, or if they're using particular anti-airs, you can... Or just if they're not like ready for... Like, I'm jumping in from here. It just goes really far.
Also good, to build meter.
Good for what?
Building meter.
Yeah. It's good for building meter. If you neutral jump a fireball, you can like Tatsu on the way down and get some meter back. And I think you can actually... No. Hold on, jump for me. I want to see the... I think it leaves the opponent really far away. It wasn't that far. Hold on, let me try this. This is going to be nuts. No way. I can't combo an ultra there. Another Sakura Tatsu. Do I have more than one? I like check to see if I had this one. I didn't see it in my channel. I might have forgotten to add it to the list. It'd be funny if I already recorded one. I don't think I've ever recorded a tutorial twice yet. Or I think I started to one time. And there's a character I already had. How many has he done since I've been gone? Anyway, let's talk about her ultras. We've already pretty much covered everything. Just as a general rule, Ultra 1 does marginally more damage than Ultra 2 in the main setup, which is EX Tatsu. Ultra 2, by contrast, works in a couple scenarios that Ultra 1 doesn't. Ultra 1 also goes through fireballs, actually. You, again, probably won't land it like that, but it does work. So it's good to be aware of. And it's invincible, and it's a much better reversal than Ultra 2 is. But you shouldn't be using Ultras like a reversal, especially not at Sakura, who can set them up easily for days. Light DP in the corner is an Ultra 2. You can actually do low forward EX Fireball, FADC, like fucking Ryu, and combo an Ultra, not Ultra 1, Ultra 2 like that. You would never do that because Sakura's just got EX Tatsu, which is still safe, so you don't need to do anything. She's got a lot of Ultra setups, but most people just only use, there you go. Most people just only use EX Tatsu because it's so good. It like outclasses all of her other setups. It does more damage, it like uses less juggle potential, it like combos from more ranges, it uses less bar. It's just a wonder kind of a special move. So just always use EX Tatsu all the time forever when playing Sakura. Literally, I feel like almost all of your bars should go there, but it's worth mentioning that EX DPF ADC is kind of important, and that's three bars, so you have to be somewhat conservative with your meter if you ever want to have reversals. But I can't stress enough how good it is to just do something like this. Like, let's say block for me, Sephiroth. If you get, like, a EX Tatsu going on a crouching opponent, you can just, like, get a pressure into another one. I can't talk about how often that fucking works. Just because the opponent tries to hit something after an EX Tatsu.
Or even better.
Yeah. Ah, yes, burn it all. Burn it all. I see that work. I really see that work. People will just stop blocking eventually, and then all of a sudden they'll get hit. Or, like, if you do three of them, like, no one's gonna tech that throw. If you do three of them and you have four bars, and you just walk in for a throw. It's like, surprise, motherfucker. Stuff like that really works, as stupid as it sounds.
Actually, after a block EX Tatsu...
Yeah? Oh, sorry, I didn't block.
A really good counter hit setup? Down Pierce.
Walking down Pierce or just down Pierce by itself? That actually looks really good. Wow.
Because you're typically far enough away that a light one isn't gonna reach.
Well, I grabbed it. That was cool.
Yeah, you did. You can grab it, but... like, if you crouch check it.
Yeah, I see it. Soccer with their stubby ass normals. Tricky, tricky! Alright, so for the most part, our ultras are interchangeable. They're, like, most soccer players tend to go for Ultra 2 these days, but there's a decent number who play either of them. I wouldn't pick Ultra Double, though. The reason is, the reason you pick Ultra 1 is because it does more damage than Ultra 2. And if you pick Ultra Double, you're never gonna use, like, you would use Ultra 1 if you picked Ultra Double. But if you're gonna, like, Ultra Double, Ultra 1, does less damage than just Ultra 2. So you wouldn't pick... There's no reason to have that Ultra 1 part of Ultra Double, because it's just going to be doing less damage than just picking raw Ultra 2. So either pick, I think, 1 or 2 for Sakura. I would never pick Double. I guess a case could be made that you could use it for Ultra 1's invincibility plus like the versatility of Ultra 2, but that's just like a really shitty reason. Let's see here. Combos. That's cool. Cool combo. Don't ever do that. General punish combo would probably be something like Stand Fierce EX Tatsu, followed by Ultra or Atoshi or something, and that'll do pretty good damage. That's like just like complete baby combo. And if you don't have the bar, you would do like an uppercut, and that's another complete baby combo. If you want to start throwing links into the mix, then you'll probably do something like if you don't want to use like hard links, let's say you only want to use 2-frame links, you could do something like that. It's a very common combo. Stand Fierce, Light Tatsu, Stand Short, Fierce DP. You can use Stand Jab, Low Forward as well on most characters. I'll give it a couple guns. That jab is kind of hard on Tatsu and Sakura. I tried. That shouldn't even be that hard. But that jab is weird on her. I'll use it after Stand Forward. I still missed it. That's like a reasonable combo to go for, and there's some characters that's really good on. On some characters, you can actually do like Stand Jab Crutch Fierce, and that gets you a wacky setup. I don't know if Sakura is one of them. Yeah, like that'll hit deep on some characters. I think Cody and Rolento, and I forget. Like some characters that'll just get a really cool connect. Anyway, if you want to, the best if you only want 2-frame links. The best combo is close medium kick, Tatsu, close hard punch, Tatsu, or EX Tatsu. Like, meterless would be that, That's a really good meterless combo, 332. That's probably about as good as it gets for Sakura, unless you have a shit ton of one-frame links. But that's like 332 on a grounded connect. Like, for comparison, like, Adon gets 250. And Adon's got, like, I mean, it's like low average. I just always use Adon as my example for whatever reason. Ryu gets, like, 250. Ryu gets a little more if he uses Torrid Spheres. But the point is, that's just a lot of damage. I think Ryu gets 260. And if you want to burn the bar, you would cut the second light Tatsu for an EX Tatsu. So you do like, I dropped it. You do that. Let me give it a go just to get the damage value. It's a failed blink. Failed blinks. $359. Quite respectable damage. That one's more from the knockdown and the fireball. Or the ultra or whatever. Whatever you have. It's really easy to make decisions about how much meter you want to use for Sakura. Because it's usually 1 or 0. Optimal meterless punish combos. Raw, Tatsu, close hard punch, Tatsu, crutch hard punch. That changes a lot depending on the character. Yan and Yang, it's I think it's close medium kick starter. Close medium kick, light Tatsu, close medium kick, light Tatsu, crouch fierce, light Tatsu, crouch fierce, light Tatsu, low forward, uppercut.
Yeah, if you play Sakura, you're gonna have to get the fact that everything with Sakura's Tatsu is character specific.
Yeah, you got a lot of the you have like I think close fierce, light Tatsu, crouch fierce works on everyone, and no, you have a couple combos to just work on everyone. What? That doesn't work on DeCapri either.
Work on DeCapri.
Damn, Sakura has a hard time. Close forward, crouch, fierce should be a link that works on everyone, I'm pretty sure.
I think that.
But you got options to work on everyone. You can generally go into Sand Short too. Sand Short tends to work. We just use Sand Short because it's the farthest range 3-frame normal she has. So usually you want to go into, but you can usually go into crouch fierce for a bit more damage. There are very few ranges where crouch fierce doesn't work. That's like a common one frame one. If you want a one frame punish, you do stand fierce and then crouch fierce. That's like really common. That does really respectable damage. And then you can do, then you would do stuff like this after a focus attack too. And focus attacks are really good for Sakura, so this is like, you'll be doing these combos all the time. Nice pretend combo. That's a nice link. And then, what else? She's got like a lot of weird options here. This is just, it like spreads around a lot. You can always end with either an EX Tatsu or a light Tatsu stand short uppercut for the most part. Oh yeah, and if you don't have the bar, you can do stuff like, you can just use hard uppercut enders. But there are combos where it really sucks. Like that one, you don't want to drop that. It's a one frame length that sucks to drop. But if you're good, you can go for combos like that. That looked like a deep connect. We might actually have a cool combo there. Nah, looked different that time. Well, how weird. That should be the same every time. Two crouch faces might do it. On some characters you can do like, oh yeah, you can you can red focus any fierce normal or any TP. That's usually not useful for Sakura because she already has like safe EX Tatsus. On some characters she can do that, but I guess that doesn't work on Sakura. Which is kinda sad. That actually worked. Okay, you can use short there. I mean strong there. And then you can combo low short after that. Or not. Alright, Sakura's weird. Lots of character specific stuff. End of story. Alright, let's talk about hit confirms. A really common one is low short, low jab, low fierce. I would call it the baby hit confirm. It's not the easiest hit confirm she has, but it's like the most general. And then from that you can go for hard Tatsu, EX Tatsu, hard uppercut. Those are all like decent finishers. Yeah, light works on a lot of characters, but I guess not Sakura. And then on some on the characters where light Tatsu works, you can generally do like stand short, and then you can do enders into left forward as well. Those are cool because you can actually get three light normals there, so you have a little bit of extra like hit confirming time. You can use like two low shorts to get extra low hits, and maybe the opponent stops blocking low or stuff like that. So that ends up being pretty useful. That's a pretty good hit confirm that I keep on dropping. That's like a 3-frame link too, that's the embarrassing part. Damn. Always the same part. It's because my hands are moving. That's the reason. I'm like moving over, I'm changing blocking directions. Oh, you get it. You're good at that combo. That's like a, that's a very general hit confirm. And you can just do that just from like a stand jab, low forward. If you're really good, that's a hit confirm for you. You can just do like stand jab, low forward. And if you see the stand jab work, you can cancel the low forward on reaction. Chris Xie does that all the time. Very common combo for him. Oh yeah, I didn't even mention that. If you're doing combos into, if you're in the corner and you're doing combos into what would be an EX Tatsu, you can end with a, if you've got Ultra 2, you can end with a light DP instead. So let's say if I got a cornered opponent, I could do like, I dropped it. Let me actually do something like, hold on. I'm dropping every combo I go for. Let me just do Stand Fierce Crouch Fierce. Damn. Why am I not getting that? This combo's too hard for me. Whatever. The point is you can end combos. Let me just do a light stand short. Let me do a stand short. I still can't hit it. Impress me. Impress me, Sephiroth.
Oh, come on.
Be the combo guy I can't be. You dropped it too. Ah, that'd be tricky. That's actually very tricky. It might be some wonkiness that it's not being able to hit on the first frame. Oh no, you got it. There it is. Weird just suck. Me in particular. But end with light DP on cornered opponents. And then from there. Land your Ultra 2s. You have to use up Ultra 2 there, I think. Up Ultra 2 comes out generously faster. I didn't even mention this, but Ultra 2 can be used as an anti-air, but it's surprisingly small. It looks like it'd be really big, but it's not. I think I won't even get you in time. Yeah. It's not that hard to jump over. It is an okay anti-air, though. And you can actually Ultra 1 anti-air as well, but it's a lot more precise. It requires them to hit a button mid-air. Or you can do it really early mid-air and then, like, fucking they land into the kick. That'll never happen. It is really fun. It's really weird when only the kick lands, because it's, like, not supposed to work like that, so it doesn't play out properly. Wow, that's a hard knockdown. I guess I'm not surprised there's an Ultra.
I have seen that, that trade.
Trade?
And then you can get a DP after.
Fucking, that's like combo video stuff. That's pretty much it for Sakura, dude. I can't think of anything else. We got like all our EX special moves.
Here's some trivia.
Okay.
If you change the version of Sakura back to anywhere before Ultra, her back throw animation is different. She has this weird like clip. Where she doesn't, like, the velocity on her movement just stops for a second, right there. And old versions don't have that.
Yeah.
She goes fully, like, the velocity keeps going. It's weird.
It's because they wanted her to recover close to the opponent, and they didn't know how to do it.
Yeah.
That used to leave the opponent just full screen. Yo, you know that animation I can't stand is Sakura is Lena's forward throw. Because, like, it makes the sound effect of light normals. It just feels really weak. It just kicks you 3 times in the face. And it just looks really, like, bad. Sakura's forward throw has a much better OP scenario than her back throw does. Ooh, that was cool. I forgot about it. Jump Fierce has, like, it's really easy to get the cross-up Jump Fierce in the corner. And on some characters, that's unblockable. Unlike Sagat, I think. They might have fixed Sagat. But on some characters, that's unblockable. Damn, you can convert that. That would have been an uppercut. I think I'm done with shit to say for Sakura, then. Cool. Thanks for helping out for these two.